former President Obama is literally going to have his head implode, then explode, then implode again if the FCC is successful in doing something that's literally about to screw over every internet user in the country. If there was any accomplishments that Obama had that were worth enjoying, it was the fact that net neutrality meant that greedy cable companies like Comcast, who has horrible customer service, couldn't charge different fees based on what you use the internet for. For example, if the net neutrality laws weren't passed, then internet providers could literally charge different rates based on what you're doing on the internet. If there's any fee on a bill that would be BS, that would be it. If you're paying for internet service each month, then that's all you need to do. It should not matter if you use that internet to check email, stream movies, or play games. You're already paying a premium price for your connection and speed. Net neutrality would wreak havoc on everyone's pockets. Republicans and Democrats would both be screwed in this effort to tack on another charge to ever-increasing bills from cable companies. You would think that with all the billions that a company like Comcast has, that they could maybe have a better selection on their on-demand service. And just maybe their customer service could be tolerable. This is where it gets ugly. The FCC chairman, a presumed jackass named Ajit Pai, wants to roll back the net neutrality rules. I don't know whose hand he's shaking in a dark alley, but he's certainly getting his pants stuffed with a few dollars from someone if he's successful in screwing over every hard-working, paying customer of internet in America. This is bigger than a Republican vs. Democrat thing. This is a handful of people reaching deep into your pockets when they're already billing you at rates higher than normal. Federal Communications Commission Chairman Ajit Pai's plan to roll back net neutrality rules took its first step forward on Thursday. The commission voted 2-1 along party lines to advance Pai's Restoring Internet Freedom proposal, which would repeal current net neutrality protections. Thursday's vote opens a period of public input before the agency advances the proposal. The FCC's formal decision to consider the proposal did not come without resistance. The commission's lone Democrat, Mignon Clyburn, harshly criticized the proposal, and activists braved the heat to protest outside FCC headquarters. This is one of the few times that I agree with a Democrat because if net neutrality is screwed up, then you and I are paying more. It doesn't matter if we're Republican or Democrat when our money is green. That's all they want. It's a massive money grab when it doesn't need to be. The majority of internet customers are the working middle class. Poor people don't pay much for their cable or internet. Rich people don't really care what the bill is. This is about the middle class and keeping our young entrepreneurs and blue-collar workers with a few bucks in their pocket to enjoy for themselves and stimulate the economy buying things way better than paying for increased cable rates. Pai wants to continue the Trump administration's assault on free speech and political dissent, and hand over control of the internet to his corporate cronies at AT&T, Comcast, and Verizon, said Free Press Field Director Mary Alice CRIM. Free Press and groups such as the American Civil Liberties Union, Electronic Frontier Foundation and Color for Change have rallied their supporters to demonstrate against Pai's plan. Pai stinks and Trump is an idiot if they pursue this. There's literally no reason to mess with something that is not broken. Of all the things in the country to work on, this should not be on the list. Most people hate the FCC. Supporting them is idiotic and delusional. You may as well fork over the rest of your paycheck and stick to drinking the $2 beers at happy hour. People don't realize it, but the more you pay for internet, then the less you're paying elsewhere. This will slowly cause a decrease in other portions of the economy if people get shanked by the FCC or the massive cable providers in their thirst for rate increases and poor customer service. HBO's John Oliver has already urged viewers of his show to do the same. The comedian is encouraging individuals to visit govccyourself.com, which redirects to the Restoring Internet Freedom proposal. Obama was a golfing vacationer, but I enjoyed watching the FCC get shut down on their net neutrality ways. The FCC is the worst thing to happen to American media.
Please do not forget to subscribe and like and comment because we want to hear your voice and thank you for watching.